Hi, it's Elsie. Welcome to my channel. With this video, I want to show you how I create this edit using Pixar and CapCut. I will also show you how you can use the crop function or mask function to create the split screen effect on CapCut. Now let's get started. First, I'm going to show you how you can use the crop function to create the split screen. As you can see here, I have three videos, so I'm going to create three split screen. First, I'm going to change the format of this, so click on Format. I'm going to select 9 to 16. You can select whatever you want based on how you want the split screen to be. Then I'm going to use the crop function to crop the video to the size that I want. So click on the video, then click on Edit, Crop. You can do your own ratio or you can select the one here. I'm just going to select 16 to 9. Just do the same thing with the other two videos. Now we are going to move two of them to the overlay track so they are all on the same timeline. So click on overlay, click on the clip, then click on overlay again. Do the same thing with the other video. Now you can move them to the position that you like. You can also change the background by click on canvas, color, select the color that you like. So that's how you can create three split screen. We can also add animation to it. So you can click on the clip, click on animation, in. You can do whatever animation, but I'm going to do slide left for the first one. Then click on overlay to add animation to the other two. I'm going to add the slide right animation for the second one. And for the last one, I'm also going to add the animation slide left. So that's how you can use the crop function to create the split screen with animation. Now let me show you how you can create the split screen with the mask function. As you can see here, I already add in the pictures that I want to create the split screen and move the other pictures to the overlay track. I have a total of 5 pictures. To create split screen, you can just adjust them to the position you like. I'm going to start with the last one first. So move it to the position that you like. Can adjust it or rotate it. Then you can click on mask. For the edge one, I'm just going to use the split mask. Then arrange it to how you like. You can do straight or diagonal, depends on how you like it. Then get to the next picture that you want to create the split screen. Then click on mask again. For this one, I'm going to use fill strip. Adjust it to how you like. Just do the same thing with the other picture. Fill strip. Then for the first one, I'm going to use split again. So that's how you can create the split screen using the mask function. Now let's add animation to them. So click on the first one, animation, in. Then click on slide right. Then click on the second picture. Trim off that first part. Then click on animation again, in. Slide right, then get to the third picture, trim off that part, then just add in the same animation. You would repeat this process with the rest of 4 pictures. As you can see, some of the pictures are coming from the bottom. It's not as smooth, so we are going to make sure that in the right order. To do that, you can click on the clip, click on layer, then you can change the order of them. And go to the third one, layer. This one should be on number 2. And this one is on number 3. So the main video always will be on the bottom. So this is how you can create split screen using the mask function. You might consider using the crop function if you want to use effect like frame. Let me show you why. So let me click on effects. Go to frame. then select any frame. As you can see here, the frame is not really showing. Let's change it to another one. As you can see with this one, it also didn't really show. The reason is because when you apply the frame effects to them, it still applies to the original picture. So if you want to use frame effect to your video, you might not want to use the mask function. Instead, you can use the crop function, or let me show you how I use PicsArt. Open PicsArt with the picture that you want to create a split screen. So I'm going to use this picture. What I did is just add in the PNG photos of each character here. So make sure it's in the right ratio. For this one, I'm going to do 16:9. To do that, you can go to Tools, Crop, and you can click on 16:9. So this way you know it's in the right ratio. Now we are going to create split screen for each one. Depends on how many split screen you want to create. We are going to divide it, the first number, the width, by 5. So you can do A15 or A16. So I'm going to do A15. And then you can crop it like that, or you can zoom in to how you like. Then click on apply, and then click on save. Then click on undo, and repeat this process. Go to tools, crop. Change it to A15, then just do the same thing with the rest of the character. Now open these pictures in CapCut. Now you want to move the character's picture to the overlay track. For the one in the middle, we are going to make a copy of it. And then we are going to move them to the overlay track. Now move the character picture to the position that you like. Then edit them based on the bit. So go to the first bit, click on the first picture, then trim it to match the bit, and the last picture as well. Then we are going to add in animation to them. So click on animation, in. Then for this one, we are going to do slide up. Duration will be 0.2 seconds. Click on the next one. Animation, in. We are going to do slide down, 0.2 second duration. Then get to the next bit and edit the next two pictures. Then click on the clip to add animation as well. So click on animation, in. Then I'm going to do slide up for this one, 0.2 second duration. For the other one, in. Then do slide down. 0.2 seconds. Now we are going to trim the last picture, get to the bit. For the end part, we're going to trim it to match the end of the first one. Then on the last one, you're gonna click on the clip, add in a keyframe at the beginning, and then move it to the next bit, which is about 0.2 seconds. Add in another keyframe, then go back to the first one, click on mask, split, do the same thing with the other one, mask, split, but for this one we are going to click on invert, and then move it down to the bottom of the screen, then go to the first one, do the same thing, move it out of the screen. So this is how it would look like. Now we are going to add effects to them. So you can click on effects, then click on whatever effect you like. I'm going to do the LED frame. Then I'm going to make 5 copies of it. I'm going to make some final adjustment to the pictures. Then we are going back to the effects, click on the effects, then click on object, then apply the effect to each overlay picture. So this is how you can create a split screen. If you want to use the same music to create the same edit, I'm going to go over what I have for each one. So for the first picture, I have 2.8 seconds with the in animation, zoom out. Then for the next picture, I have 0.3 seconds with the animation, combo zoom to. And then with the next one, I don't have anything, which is 1 second. Then for the next picture, is 0.8 seconds with the animation, combo zoom to. The next picture is 1 second with no animation. The next one is 0.8 seconds, also with the animation, combo zoom to. The next one is 0.9 seconds. And then the one after that is 1 second with the animation in shake 2, duration 5 seconds. The next one is also 1 second with the shake 2 in animation. Then the next one is 0.8 seconds with the combo zoom 2 animation. The next one is 1 second with no animation. Then the one after that is 0.8 seconds with the zoom 2 animation as well. And the one after that is 1 second. And 0.8 seconds with the zoom 2 combo animation. And the last one is 1.4 seconds. I'm going to show you how I create the light effect for the picture. So I'm going to go to the third picture. Then click on overlay, add overlay. And then go to stop videos. Select the white background. And zoom in to fill in the screen. Then trim it down to 0.5 seconds. Align with the third picture. Then click on splice. Then click on overlay. Then click on animation. Out. Fade out. So that's how you can create the flashlight effect. Then you can just copy this one and apply to the rest of the pictures. I also have the white flash effect at this part, but I'm not going to add in another 6 white flash effect because that's too much. I'm just going to export this video. Then open it again, then get to the part where I want to add the white flash effect, then click on effects. Then click on party, then select white flash. Trim it to the part where you want. So that's how I create the split screen using Pixar, but you can use the crop function. However, with the crop function, it might not be as precise. You can also use the mask function, but since I want to use the frame effect, Pixar would be better. However, the Pixar method is only for pictures. So if you want to do videos, it probably would be better to use the crop function and mask function. I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you enjoy the content, please consider like, subscribe, and comment down below to help me boost the YouTube algorithm to help more people see my video. As always, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.